So when I was living in New York, I'm going to tell this story, Holmes, because you deserve it. I don't think I could ever let anybody go that I truly loved. Bit of a problem when you marry a man and he's gay. You can laugh at that, it's kind of funny. You can laugh because I tried to stay, and she said, it's not really going to work. As much as you love me, you're gay. So we were devastated, but we separated. And I separated from my wife before I'd ever held a man's hand or really, you know, done the gay thing. Well, I came out before I did that anyway. And the plan was that I would move to New York and see if I was gay. Turned out I was gay. And Colby was incredibly gracious about it, and she said, I've got a couple of rules. Don't call me for a while, you know. Anyone who's been through a breakup knows this. You need some time to stop loving each other. And I can't remember what the time frame was, but it might have been 6 months or a year or whatever, but I broke the fucking time frame because I'm a big baby. And I remember calling her up and saying, I can't do this anymore, I can't do it, I gotta kill mom, I love you. And she was like, okay, still gay? So yeah. She said, yeah, don't call me. Give me some time to get over you. And I'm so grateful that she did that, because it took a long time to get over you, but I still have you, and I love you. But I wrote this song, yes. But I wrote this song for us, and probably from her point of view, but about walking around New York, and it being incredibly cold, not just physically, but emotionally. You can give it some warmth if you want. It's called The Lover After.
Since you've been gone, the lights go out the same. The only difference is